Hi everyone. Okay, we're back and we're gonna finish this guy. Everyone has one of these, right? A simple notebook, right? I use mine to like stamp or whatever I need to do. I haven't used this in forever. Since I was doing a wedding thing. Okay, so this particular one has perforation there. So I'm just gonna take advantage of that and cut a few pages. Okay, I think that should be enough, right? All right. And now we're going to go through did I put the back on? I did. Okay. Now we're going to go through and it's a journaling book, right? So think I'm going to glue that down right there. And let me see here. Okay. I can't really glue that down because I need that mobility there for the end. Now, this one normally I would move it, center it, but because I had this, I need it to be closer to the edge so that when you flip it over, it clears that edge there. If you had it more in, it would be bending this, and that wouldn't be good. So that's why I did that. Okay, so now let's get rid of this stuff. Well, let's keep it because I might. Maybe I'll stamp on that or something. I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, I wanted to cover the inside, but I probably should have done that before. So, maybe I won't do that. Let me have a little think here. If I fold this up and tuck it under, I might be able to do that later on. I just want to make sure that stays down. I don't mind if that little edge comes up, but for the most part, I want the whole thing. Uh-oh, see now my pages are coming out. We're gonna have to work on that. No worries. This is a quick journal. So those little things are gonna happen. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my paper, and if I fold it in half, yep, okay, so let's do this again. Where's that half mark? Right there. Cool. And I could just use half. I don't need to use the whole thing. Right? Yep. Okay. So let's fold that in half. And do that. And fold this one in half, just a rough idea so we know where the center is. Like that. And I like these papers because I have that little margin on the top. So we're going to use this first, and then if we need to, go to those. Okay, so now I want to maybe ink these up, right? So we'll do alternate colors. I'll do one brown. Just go all the way around the edges. Okay. And now this can, go there, but I want to add just a little more, so I'm going to add that down, and then I'm going to glue this around, just the edge. No, I want to do the whole thing, I think, because I want to hold that in place. Okay, let's do that. Nice. I'm not going to worry about torn edges. None of that. We're doing this really quick. Okay, so that goes there. Then I want pink on my next one. Oh, I'll just move that into place. We're going to have to sew that up, but that's okay. It's okay. Pink. And I only want one. Very nice. Now, I think I want to be able to, I think I want to stamp. So before I add this one to the book, I think I'm going to get a stamp. Oh my gosh, I just dropped my stamp. Hold on, please hold. Okay. And I just have this little, because the stamp is the one that's out. I just have this this little flower here that I want to use. And let me just grab my acrylic piece here. Let's see, I gotta figure out which way it is. Okay, yep, that's good. So I don't wanna use pink, I wanna use the brown, and let's go down here. Very nice. It's just a little flower at the bottom. And I'm gonna at this page just glue the top. And that way, this one can be a flip, and you can have your private journaling down at the bottom. And now I'm gonna, let's do all the papers first, we'll decorate later. Okay, so then this one needs to be blue. So let's grab this, and let's grab my blue, and let's close this up before I get confused. And make a boo-boo. Okay. Let's go all the way around the edges. And I've got the music off again, guys. I'm sorry. I keep turning the music off because because I'm uploading and you're not here, so or I'm texting or something, and the phone rings or something. So okay, so there's that. Now I also want to stamp on this one. And again, I've got my little stamps here that from my last journal. Let's see, I'm missing, it probably fell on the floor. I want this one. Where is it at? My stamp fell, remember? So I'm sure it's on the floor somewhere. And I don't see it. Did it fall in my trash? No, I don't see it. Okay. Let's not use that one then. Let me see if I have another stamp here available. Sometimes I have stamps just laying around. Yep, I do. Okay, I have this one. So, oof, I don't want that. Let's do brown again. Okay, and let's just do it there. Cute. Just a little stamp. As we've got other stuff that we're gonna do, we just want a really light, just a tiny little stamp. And now this one, I'm only gonna go three sides, because this one can be a pocket, right? So let's bring this over so we don't have to bring the whole book over. Just put this in the middle. And I glued here, here, and here. That leaves this open for pocket. Okay, now let's flip over. So now we need brown. So let's grab this and do brown. How's my time? I hope you guys are enjoying the series. And I hope that you're learning a quick way, this new method. Not new, it's not new. It's just a different way of creating a really quick book. Okay, that's good. Now I really, really, really want a stamp. I don't have one here. I usually have stamps everywhere. Okay, I'm just going to use that border one. I'm going to use this little border one. Maybe this one. I'll just put it on this end. Okay, so. And now because we did, oh, you guys can't see. Because we did a flip up and this pocket. Now when we do this side, let's do like a tuck, right? So if it goes like this, we're just gonna glue here and here, two sides. Okay. Let's do that here and here. Now we have a tuck. Nice. And now because we're getting towards, let's see, how many of these do we have? One, two, three. So one, two, and then the last one. But we really don't need one on the last one, so. Okay, that's good. I'm just trying to, I know you can't see me. You don't need to see me doing anything over there. I'm just trying to figure out what we're doing here. So I'm going to go back to pink. That's what I'm trying to do. Trying to figure out what color to go back to. So I got my pink. And I got my pink. Just about done here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Like a little, since I have all these extras, I'm gonna flip them over different ways like that and turn that one that way
like that. Right? Yep. And I'm going to stagger them here on the top. Like that. But I don't want to stagger them that way. I want to stagger them the other way. Okay, so let's bring this over. We have that, that. We're going here. Okay, so we want there, and there, and there, and there. Okay, so actually we want here, and I want this ragged edge down here. So I'm gonna go here and add glue, and then I'm gonna go here. And add glue, and then up, turn this way. How can I get that line like that? Okay, I guess that's what's the only way I can do it. So glue. And then this one, glue, and I'm just going right above it. And then this one on the top, right over everything. But I want that edge to show just right there. Just this edge here. Okay. And this is brown. I'm going to get just a scrap piece of paper here. As I should have inked them all already, but it's okay. We can still ink while it's in the book. Awesome. And we want blue. Uh-oh. There. Okay, then we want blue. We don't need that much. Okay. And then we want pink. Let's grab the pink. Woof. A lot of time spent just inking. Okay, and the last one, brown. Wow, that worked out pretty good. Okay, let's close you up. And bring you back. Okay, almost done here. How's our time? I want to finish this in this last little video here, but I might have to come back. Well, I mean, we still got to decorate, so we're not all the way done, but we're partial done. Okay, there we go. Nice. Okay, and then now this goes here, right? So here and here. Why don't we leave it so that we can get to decorating? And I should have added the tool. But that's okay. We'll be okay. Let's do that. This is supposed to be a super simple project. So I'm going to put these aside because we might come back to them. Okay, and I'm going to move this over out of the way. We're not inking anymore. And we're not going to be cutting paper. Okay, let me just clean this up just a tad. Okay. So I'm going to just cut that there. And why not use some of this? So let's do 3 hearts. How about just a little bit offset? And oh yeah, I need to burn off those edges. Yep. Okay. And we'll center it. And actually, let's use hot glue. Right there. Right there. And right there. Okay, super simple, right? Just lay a piece of lace down. Done. Okay, up here, I wanted to put the pink, right? So we can use this pink, or we can use this pink. We can cut this off as a trim. I love using laces in different ways. It's good right there. Gorge, isn't that pretty? Oh my gosh, that's so pretty. And we need glue. Not a lot of glue, just enough. Gorgeous. And yep, I didn't do this side, so let's do something here. Let's use up our scraps. This was the doily, remember? But if we pull it straight, might be too dark against the white, so let's not do that. Let's use this one. We haven't used this one yet. Gorgeous. And it's perfect. And I think I can put a little brown on there, just a little. Right? Just a little. Gorge. And I also have a brown Sharpie. It's permanent, a permanent marker. So let's do a little designing. I'm going to hold it here so it doesn't move. Here and here. I'm just doing loops. Pretty? Okay, and then this one, what can we do? Let's do this. Pretty? Okay, and then this one, I haven't doodled in forever. So let's do this and a circle. Cool. Well, this one should have been a loop. Like that. Just make it a little bit frilly. Okay. Oh, I just love doodling, and I haven't doodled in forever. Once you get started doodling, you can spend a lot of days. Okay, and now I'm gonna just... I'm going to move this over. I'm just going to glue here and here, and then that can be a little tuck. Or, yeah, it's too wide that way. So let's do that. So a little bit on the top there. And a little glue on the bottom here. Glue strings. All over my fingers. Okay, that's awesome. Then we can do a little, we have a little tuck there. Cool. So very simple journal, little lace, a little lace and decoration there. But when we do that, no, you know what? I'm gonna put that across there, just a little extra bigger. Yep, because I kind of want to conceal that number 77 there. There we go. Oops. There. Awesome. Okay, and then here, since this is the center, we want to do kind of the same but different. So here, I'm just gonna do it this way. And I'm gonna go right over that hole. Nice. Just take that glue off of there. I'm not too worried because I'll probably cover that. Okay, turn. We have a few minutes left. Okay, these I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna leave these blank. Okay, yeah, I think we're good. All I have to do now is sew this, which I don't have my needle and thread yet. So I'm going to stop here and then we're going to come back one more time to finish this up. I'm still thinking, what can I do here? But I should just follow along the same lines and just add. So that's what I'll do off camera. I'll just add two pieces of paper here. You guys don't need to see me do that. And when I come back, then we'll decorate them. Okay. Bye, everyone. I hope you're having fun. Thank you so much, Natasha. I know I'm having fun. Please don't forget, all the links are down below. And visit the other designers. And come see our Facebook page. And don't forget the discount code. And you cannot use a discount code on sale items. So only on regular priced items, please. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching. And God bless. Bye, everyone.